Hello and welcome to Rage Across the Amazon. As we begin our scene in the Umbra, the very unstable Umbras of the Amazon that can truly just change in a matter of seconds, depending on the will and whims of the wild. As we home in on a curious white wolf, actually a wolf, not a man this time. Wandering around in the Umbra, and it's a confusing landscape as Jacob has found it. That seems to constantly shift and drive and really make his navigation quite irritating, considering the simplicity of the task he set before himself, which is finding a fairly small cub. Which perhaps is a complicated task, as her small stature gives her the ability to hide in the smallest of arenas. But Jacob, nonetheless, feels he is on the right track. Having discovered some clue, he's in Lupus, perhaps her scent, perhaps he just saw her moving through the encampment at some point, And oh yeah, I'll roll perception survival. Let's do it. I have reindeer's favor. I get automatic 3 dots in survival. Let's go. Oh man. Okay.
Wow.
Why? Why are you making me roll this now, asshole? Really? I could use that like a scene ago when I used sense worm on the fucking Afro Battlemaster.
It's okay. You can follow the trace of salt leave left by the Wendigo cubs.
Yes. Oh man, the salt is real this time. I mean, it's just, the Amazon is made up of fresh water, so the existence of salt all over the place doesn't really make sense to Jacob, and his detective senses are tingling as he follows this trail of cold hatred and sorrow.
That sounds like a proper Wendigo trail, yeah. As far as you following that trail, in the end you come to a pool. It's still on sept ground, so moving around the Umbra isn't too difficult. As you come upon this pool, you can see, the thing that is probably less or least moving, which is Tlatehin. She is sitting with her feet in the water, and there is a water spirit kind of coiled around her legs, almost as if it's sitting on her lap, and they seem to be conversing. Since you don't have spirit speech, all you hear is kind of just watery noises. And I guess you will see a pretty bored Tapisa somewhere around, or maybe you won't see her. I'll leave that up to the player.
Well, no, I mean, I'm pretty sure that if Latihin is busy talking bubbles, Tapisha, for her part, she's more busy with with the ice elemental that always roams around her, you know, giving a very nice fresh breeze, making it, you know, 20 degrees and not fucking wall of humidity in your face around her. So yeah, she's patiently waiting for her sister to stop bubbling.
Patiently.
Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I know,
patiently.
Exactly. Yeah, I know, exactly. She's completely bored out of her ass, and she's pacing with her ice elemental, because at least he understands. He understands the nature of boredom. I know he can talk back to me because he speaks in ice, but we get each other. There's the connection.
Yeah, when he got the urge, we'll look up to his sister from time to time, actually. And like for the third or the fifth or whatever, seventh time in the last 10 minutes, she'll ask Tvisa, do you want me to stop so and we can go? Like, I can do this later, but I promised them stories.
What? No, 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 I'm fine. I'm completely fine. I don't know what you mean. She probably stopped, but then, you know, her right feet is doing pump, 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 pump. As if she physically needs to move. It's just really, it's more frustrating to hear you speak bubbles, and I don't understand bubble language.
Well, I can translate for you if you like, or I can ask. I don't know if the spirits can speak either Guru or English or even in Oxitoke. I doubt the latter now.
As you say that, she actually sits. She actually sits, and the ice elemental just lands on her head. Oh, you can translate. Great. Like, that'll be way more interesting. I mean, he's a nice fellow, but you know, ice can go so far. My ice language goes so far.
You want me to translate what your Newman is saying?
I mean that would be great, but I would actually be more interested in stories.
Okay. And Tlatine will start to translate what the spirit is speaking of. This is how Jacob defines this, like, strange duo.
Yes. you may find Wendigo cubs in their natural environment without being surrounded by wormcomers. One might say they almost seems normal.
Almost.
Preposterous.
Wendigo happy? Please. Allow me to crash this beautiful illusion. As Jacob, all of you, it's extremely apparent, a white wolf shows up. Kind of again openly, it's not hiding, and you know, it sticks out. This is not the environment a wolf of this color or kind of this thickness of fur coat really belongs in, and it seems to appreciate the colder breeze. It shows respect to spirits. You can smell that. This wolf smells a lot like Silver Fang. Of course, Tlate already knows who this is.
She'll she notices this wolf approaching. She will apologize to the spirit and tell that story. Our will continue in a bit. Kind of push it. Well, not necessarily push it away, but she will roll over and the spirit will probably slide back into the water, looking a little bit confused as to what this sea urge is doing now. And she'll look at the pizza.
Yeah, she... I mean, she's going to look at that guy. Oh, that's right. It's that guy. I'm gonna roll something.
Is this another sass roll?
No, this is not yet.
Empathy?
It's manipulation subterfuge.
I'm gonna need to roll empathy. I don't have a lot of empathy.
Allow me to roll a minus two diff because FML. Oh, you succeed.
Yes, I succeed.
And
how many successes did you have?
I had three successes.
Nope, I only have one.
Yeah, I mean, she is completely calm. There's nothing that breaks her poker face.
But she still hasn't rolled, so at this point,
That's the thing. She does. She keeps just a neutral expression.
Okay, so she did roll over.
Yeah, no, because for a second I was like, what does Saskia want to tell me? And I'm like, oh yeah, that's right, rolling over. It's a thing.
You're no longer fucking Ayden anymore.
Afro, ma'am. I'm no longer an Afro.
Whatever.
Beard that has knowledge over everything, and I can't spirit speech anymore.
Get so used to it, scrub.
So Tapisa presumably rolls over.
Yes, presumably.
If it takes longer than a second after the Tlatine is rolled over, there will be a nudging.
Oh yeah, no, she just no, she wouldn't take that long. It's just, oh, you rolled over. Because she probably, from her point of view, it's more, there's a smell. What's that smell? And then she realized, oh, that's a Garu. Roll over. It's her thought process.
Gain wisdom. Jacob will kind of just nip them both, acknowledging them to get up.
Yep, gets up again. Just for the sake of funny, the spirit, the water spirit, will probably crawl back up on Tlatahin again. It's like, where did you go? Because spirit magnet and water spirit heritage, it's a thing.
Yes, it's a thing.
Yep. After they get up and the water spirit seems to wrap itself in Talate's loving arms. Jacob will just say, hello, Tlate and Tapisa, I think. Am I correct? We haven't been formally introduced.
go on.
Oh, I just came by to see how you were doing after what happened earlier. Guys disappeared for a while.
We had a task, Jacob Pryor.
Oh, do tell.
Yeah, as she sits, want me to tell it? As she looks at Latehin, who seems to be probably having a very demanding water spirit, going like, pet me! Pet me!
She looks at me and is like, well, you are the Galliard.
You're right, Chris. It's the problem. Like, all your worm comers smell the same. It's confusing. And she looked at Jacob. We've been sent on a mission by Resfire. He wanted us to check on worm activities. around the Amazon River. So we went there, and as we came closer by, we saw that there was a drone who was, well, observing or guarding the space, and before we started shifting into the Umbra, we saw water spirits as she takes a look at the water spirit, like trying to make a comparison with her memory. Like, okay, is that the same thing? Yeah, it's the same thing.
Nothing will nod in approval.
Yep. The water spirits were out of the Umbra, and according to the older theaters, gauntlet was thinning. I mean, I have to say, generally, I have some difficulty to sidestep, but this one was quite easily to step across. And when we went to the other side, that's when we saw birds, but really crappy-looking bird. Like, I think a vulture looks way more appealing than this. And, well, before we even knew what was happening, combat ensured, we killed them rather easily, except the last one who was a bitch. We had to go at 3 on it to even kill it. It even resisted decimate Raya for a good while. But we managed to kill them while the theaters were apparently working on some runes, if I'm correct. And they stopped the summoning of a bigger creature, which I'm going to try to recheck to see if I can pronounce it correctly. because where is it? Nihilach. Yes. A bringer of apocalypse and destructor of spiritual essence. So, yeah, I think all in all, we didn't got any dead, even if apparently Kumbhakarna frenzied. I think it was because of one of the birds. Like it shrieked really loud, and then he started foaming. That's when Decimate Raya just jumped on him, burying him under the fur.
Makes sense. Come to Fiat himself, I think. He's usually been pretty calm when I've seen him.
She shrugs. I don't know. I don't really know him that much.
Jacob looks at Tlate.
Was busy with the spirit because the player was distracted for a moment. Just now looking at you because there's a silence, and she's looking at the two of them.
He just literally just like briefly looks at Tlate, then looks back to Tapisa. Says, yeah, he's been with his pack mostly recently. Let's just say it always.
coming to see us for a reason, Raya? She's like, yeah, I did my job. I'm like, what else? What else do you want?
It's 5 o'clock. My shift is over. No. After what happened with the chorus, I just wanted to see how Tlate was doing.
She, seems to freeze for a moment, and I hate the plus one on socials. That I also have.
How do you feel?
Me only one success.
How does it feel to make everyone think of Corax as a spirit? How embarrassing is that for
you? She says, I am fine.
Yeah, so and
she says that, but you can see like her mouth twitching and like her shoulders sag a little. She does her best to hide it with like a smile, but that smile looked fake as fuck.
Jacob will simply feign ignorance and just say, good, there's no shame in it. I think he was pulling a bit of a ragabash on you.
Yeah, so funny.
Is that actually what she says?
She's trying to act along and to be like, yeah, no, this is not bothering me in the slightest. But oh,
so,
God.
So funny. Ha ha ha.
I'm happy right now. It's literally, she's just pulling an eel. Jacob, he finds it a bit harder to feign ignorance after the atrocious laugh that comes out of her mouth.
I mean, on other circumstances, Tapisha would be kind of proud because that's the best cynic answer that she that Hint said. I know.
Yeah.
Awkward silence.
It did.
Yeah. The Bishop, for her part, she's just looking between the two of them as if she was judging the situation.
Well, humor is half the tale. He was obviously doing it to spread a lesson, which is why I mentioned the ragabash thing.
Fatine is looking at her knees. I know.
And better be forced into a mistake now than later. I certainly made my fair share.
Yeah. Shifts uncomfortably. It seems kind of obvious that she's actually looking around to see if there's anything that she can say. Like, so, the Umbra, right? It's difficult. Here.
I
Yes, the Umbra is indeed difficult. As she's looking at Jacob with I know she hasn't lost some of her hair, but she's throwing, you know, the stare of change the fucking subject.
Yeah, it was a pain in the ass to get here.
Yeah, I've been training to get more familiar with it.
Hey. By the way, as she has an idea. Latihin.
Yeah.
You know, that thing that we saw.
What thing?
The bringer of apocalypse.
Nihilach.
Yes, Nihila. Actually, could you tell me a little bit more about the worm and its servant? Because I'm pretty sure that learning things, you know, might help me to survive in the long term. You know, learning how to recognize the bad guy and how to beat the ever-living crap out of them. And also not getting their name incorrectly, because that would be quite stupid for a Galliard.
I can teach you what I've been taught, if you wanna.
Oh yeah, I won. As I'm not saying she completely shut off Jacob, but yeah, clearly, I mean, everyone can throw. Everyone can throw a Kiani if they want. I will roll my.
I'm glad I have to reduce the reduced difficulty.
I mean, she's pretty obvious about what she's doing, so I will not use merit on things. So yeah, Jacob, you clearly. I mean, that's pretty clear from the look that she's giving you. One or two time, and the way she's acting, like she is completely focusing her on a completely different subject.
Jacob kind of observes, kind of there's this kind of fascinated, a bit strong. It's like he's kind of analyzing the way these two are interacting with each other. You kind of see him looking towards you and then back towards Tlate every now and then, and it's almost like.
An anthropology book on Wendigo cards.
Yeah, I mean, by the time Jacob's done, he will.
Well, Latin is obviously ignorant about any hidden goals the Pisa might have. And she is... She's thinking about it. Yeah, I think I can teach you about the worm if you want to, but I'm not quite sure if this place would be the right place. She looks at the water spirit again.
She thinks, so there's a right place for those kind of talk? Now this time it's not even like trying to manipulate her. It's like, oh really? Like is there actually some kind of secret Garu code that say you can't speak in the open about the worm? I don't know that.
No, not really. It's just that I was in the middle of an interaction with this guy over here, and I'd like to finish that before
Of course. You know? Of course. Of course. My bad, buddy. As she looked at the water spirit with an apologetic look.
Tlate will translate.
Yes, we shall all speak in the native tongue of the bubble people.
She'll probably start to talk a little longer in the with water spirits, leaving the two of you up to your own devices for a little bit, because you know it's not really polite to just tell a spirit to shove it.
Yeah.
Hey, spirit, shove it up your ass.
Oh, and one. Oh, spirit.
And that's how another international incident happened.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, she looks a little bit at her sister, and she looks at the Jacob.
The worm comer.
Oh yeah. So you're a fiddle dogs, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Have you been doing much philodoxing?
A little bit. Nothing here, really. I've had the good fortune of not really having to adjudicate that much. Or rather, not having any incidents to adjudicate recently. Mm. So, I've mainly just been keeping my eyes open and keeping good order.
So, pretty much, she's just trying to think of a term. So, what, you're a mediator? A negotiator? Judge, jury, executioner.
Sorry, I lagged out there. My internet disconnected briefly.
The last part, you said judge, jury, executioner.
The latter, I hope not, but I'm preparing for if or when. I hope I don't run into someone who screws up badly enough that I'm going to have to do that. But knowing that we are creatures that tend to act on impulse a lot of the time.
I'm gonna roll manipulations up if you did this one.
Oh, fucking empathy your ass, baby. Let's go.
Three successes. Yeah, when you say, you know, acting on impulse, she makes the face like, oh yeah, I yeah. Nope, not me, sir. Totally not. Totally not.
Jacob kind of gives you like the old university lecturer look of don't be that guy in wolf form. it's a very fatherly look. acting on impulse. I'm preparing for if a worst case scenario happens. But if it does, presumably I'm not going to be the person who's dealing with that. Someone far higher up the food chain will be.
Mm.
But it's always good to be prepared, even if it's something as grim as that. What about yourself? How are you adapting to your role as a galliard?
Well, I mean, I always got a loud mouth, so I guess that's good. But I'm a Galliard. I mean, I don't really know what it would have happened if I was something else. I mean, genuinely, I don't really know what exactly everyone does in their spare time. But I mean, I think I'm getting the hang of it. Being a kinfolk, generally, people tell you, shut up, be pretty, do your kinfolk stuff. Now it's shut up, do the Galliard stuff. So, not that much of a difference, except that I want now, apparently, when I want to punch people through a wall, I break their skulls into pulp while doing so. And so, yeah. It's,
Yeah,
I guess the best description to put it is that it's weird.
Well, you're part of the... You were a part of the nation when you changed, weren't you?
Yes, I think the correct term is knowing kin. Yeah, I lived near Arcept most of my life. Except when I descended in bigger city to well, I guess you could put it as do my duty.
At that point, the conversation between Tlatehin and the water spirit seems to be ended, and she'll get her feet out of the water and starts listening to the conversation that the two Garou are having.
Jacob just continues briefly. Good on you, actually. You've been a part of the nation longer than I have been, and my kin and myself are actually completely unknowing. We lived in New York City all our lives. Callow, I think, unknowing kin are called. My change was my first experience to any form of nation.
I guess things must be different in the South.
According to what people have told me, I'm something of an exception. Especially among my tribe, we tend to keep pretty close tabs on our kin, so somehow we must have slipped through the net. I didn't. I don't think I had a kin fetch on me. I think it was actually coincidence that I was found rampaging through a supermarket store, well, corner shop, when I did.
So, what, you changed in a supermarket?
I am, in human society, I'm a cop.
You can load your peony.
Peony pals for the rescue.
Oh, man, I'm Ethan. No. Oh no. So you get 5 successes.
Yeah. How salty is she at this?
I mean, you know, you could have said through the conversation, you know, she's been very formal. She's been very formal with things, but yeah, when you say the word "I was a cop," like, you can definitely see, like, her eye twitch, the muscle of her hand, like, contract for a second, and you get the feeling that how can I put it with five successes? I think you can probably say that she is definitely fan of cop category at all.
Oh, she don't like Officer Clay. she don't like that one. That's a shame.
Jacob wouldn't really react to this, other than logging that information away, so it's a landmine for him not to step on later. it's cop in training, not official. And I was with my supervisor. I guess you could say it was something of a second dad to me. And he ended up getting gutted by some gangsters robbing this corner store. Basically got himself killed so me and the hostages could get out. And when I went back in, well, I think it's safe to assume what happened next from there.
She's going to nod, but she's not going to say anything. Which to her sister, she probably thinks, wow, she's... wow, maybe she's learning something.
Yeah. No.
After that, a bunch of gurus showed up, although the only one who found me who found me still left alive is caused the fury, the rest are gone. Unfortunately. He sounds like he's downplaying that loss a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And then I learned all about Venation and Gaia and all that, which has already been explained to you 20 times, so I'm not going to repeat it here.
Mm.
But yeah. I'm hoping when I get back, I can actually organize the kinfolk inside the force so we can do some good. Because Lord knows over there is certainly not happening right now.
And she nods. That would be good.
Unfortunately, me being coward has kind of set that plan back because I don't really know.
For fuck's sake!
Yes.
I mean, the way she say that would be good. It's not dripping with venom. Too much. But it's more, how can I say it? It's more in the sense as if the thing that you told and the way she's answering to it. If they do something good, that would be great. That would be a change. That's pretty much the feeling that you get.
Yeah, unfortunately me being callow means I'm basically having to work from the ground up because I don't know who any of my kin are. But I've been making inroads. So hopefully that can be something that does some good. Meld Alpha actually had a lot of friends that he used to keep us that safe. Not police, lawyers, so even worse.
I mean, she raised an eyebrow. She raised an eyebrow when you say worse, lawyers. Like, yeah, clearly, I mean, you don't need to peony that because it's like, I don't get what you mean. What do you mean by lawyers are worst?
This is pretty clear. Jake is making a joke. That lawyers are stereotypically the worst thing ever and should be purged from this planet for their heinous, wormish crimes, clearly.
I mean, is he saying that in character?
No, he was saying that in character, got that. His old alpha was a lawyer. He's not saying that.
Oh, boy.
Jacob is technically a guru lawyer. I mean,
good on you. I mean, good on you if you admit that you're a servant of a worm. Like, it's all credit to you. Like, I wouldn't come out with it.
Yeah, I guess I'm trying to pick up some of the pieces. We don't have a ton of influence in the city, despite living in the center of it.
Influence really depends on how you see things and how things work around you.
What do you mean? I'm interested.
She shrugs. She shrugs to that. I mean, I know I made a little noise or two within, and as she put air quotes, political influence in my days. Not that much, but you would be actually surprised at what a bunch of first people manifesting before your ministry and making a lot of noise can actually do. Oh, I'm gonna roll onto that.
Yeah. Damn it. Fail.
Oh, what's that obsession empathy? Is she trying to subterfuge? Yeah, I'm fucking. Oh, look at that! Would you look at that? I got four successes. Oh man, Jacob's so good at reading people.
Yeah. The thing is, Tlate knows how to piece this form of influence works. She's also aware of Jacob being a cop. So she is sitting there and she's trying to keep a straight face. But yeah, Jacob can see that bloody he knows something about the pizza that he doesn't know.
Jacob, we'll just continue again, totally feigning ignorance of the two things he's kind of gleaned from the Wendigo. As we just say, oh, you're an activist?
And she smirks. Yes. Most of the kinfolks that are working in the cities from time to time are activists. Generally, it makes things move, even if most of the time, well, we receive the sticky end of government understanding. And I think probably, you know, with the previous peony, you can start to put two and two together as to why she wouldn't be a fan of police.
Uh-huh. Jacob, again, we'll kind of just let the conversation flow naturally and won't really confront that notion. I should just say, well, as an activist, I must say I appreciate you being a more involved citizen than most. Most people in my nation don't even vote, let alone try to make a difference. So, just like to say, I appreciate that. I know you probably get it. Pretend to understand your position.
Oh, thank God. Oh, thank God.
Is that what role is that?
It was a willpower test to not throw you some sass when you said, you know, we don't do much.
He said he doesn't do much. He was saying, like, he appreciates how Topisa does stuff because he knows most people don't.
No, I know. It's just the way, you know, the way you said it, I could have gave you a beautiful comeback.
Could have sassed hard there.
Oh, yeah. She could have sassed. Yeah. But, yeah, she probably...
It's rough. Political activism should be appreciated a bit more than what it is, because most people don't really care. That's why I became a cop in the first place.
You became a cop because you wanted to be an activist?
I wanted to make a difference. Do you need to make another willpower check?
She's gonna make another wonderful manipulation subterfuge. So, Saskia, do you think that we should call all our scenes with Wendigo cubs like manipulation subterfuge?
Fuck, so close.
Nope. Tlatine is still ignorant. Like, she's really ignorant, this scene. She's clueless.
That of the Korax really threw her off, didn't it?
Yeah.
She's so sad.
She nods. She nods, and let me. I found the right word in English. I was like, okay, I want to say that, but how do I do it in English? And she nods, and she says, that's an honorable goal.
Thank you. Oh, I can't take credit for anything yet.
And as you know, probably as there's this moment of silence, Topisa realized that, hey, wait a minute.
Yeah, like her head slowly begin turning towards the latte.
Yeah, it's like there's no bubble sound anymore.
She's tricked us.
She has tricked us into socializing.
You can see Tlatine is watching the two of you. Smiling. Looks a little tired because why the fuck not?
I mean, we had a lot of activities.
Yeah. So you guys didn't do a formal introduction yet to each other?
Actually, I introduced myself yesterday, and he was there, actually.
Yeah. So...
Okay.
We technically have all the details. We haven't introduced ourselves to each other, but do we have to do that to every one person?
I mean, I don't know your Yeah, I mean, I don't know. You're the Philodox. That's, I think that's your area of expertise.
It was a rhetorical statement. You don't. I mean, if you want to, you can. And if someone asks of it, do it. But, you know, for people who are more like me, with a bit more lax, and they're already seen you introduce yourself, and never really introduced themselves and you're around, it's not really a problem.
She thinks about it. Actually, I think I'm gonna make an intelligence garrulor. Because she know, I mean, you're Rix of pure breed, but she, you're the only Silver Fang. So, yeah, no, she nods as she, you know, she remembers probably their grand Wendigo,
Wendigo
and grandma probably talking about the assholes with silver with silver fur. The silver
not
fang,
quite
the
as
silver
bad as those gray furred get assholes or those
black
fur shadow red assholes.
Or those Vienna.
Oh god, yeah, those guys, they're the worst.
But yeah, no, she looks at him, Silver Fang tribe, as she's like trying to confirm, like, is my assumption correct?
You're correct, judging by, well, you'll read, you come from a Wendigo lineage.
And she looks at Tlatehin, looks at Jacob, Tlatehin, Jacob, like, going, so, yeah, like, you know, almost doing the silent gesture through her sister to herself, like, yeah, it's not hard. It's not hard to guess.
It's not hard to guess.
Yes, somehow people have told me that I am indeed her sister. Apparently there has to be some hidden meaning that I don't know outside of physical resemblance.
Is she like asking if there's supposed to be some hidden meaning, or is she saying there isn't hidden meaning?
No, she's just saying that, like, yeah, I mean, I know we have some, you know, we have some physical resemblance, but pretty much what she's saying is that the way people tell it, it's as if there was a hidden meaning to it, like something I'm not catching on. So, did he found your tale satisfactory?
Yeah. He enjoyed hearing about the big icebergs that they have in the north. And I promised I would tell him about the rivers. And the seas and everything. And yeah, I think it's gonna be an interesting exchange. It's interesting to feel the same familiarity that I have always felt, but then so far away from home.
She's gonna nod. And then, I see. Well, if he was happy, I guess that's what matters. Like it's a chimney, right?
Yeah. No, well, yeah, sort of. We've agreed to exchange stories. They want to hear about stories from where I come from, and in return, they're going to let me know stories of this place, and hopefully, if there is anything, maybe there is something we can find that we can use that could like give a message for this big worm creature or those creatures with those blue flames coming from their mouths as Decimates described.
I mean, are we sure those are not Macaulay?
What?
I mean, okay, the description that she gave was like they are kind of dragon lizard-like. Aren't the Macaulay lizard people? Couldn't that be a Macaulay?
I've never seen a Macaulay.
She's gonna turn to Jacob. Have you seen a Macaulay?
No, but if I've heard correct, they would be large reptilian-looking creatures, like dinosaurs. They're called the Dragon Kings for a reason, I presume. He knows that because he's literally been told that like 2 days ago.
She just makes an expression as if she had an idea. Oh, I know. We should totally ask Rustfire Raya about that. As if you get probably, you know, from their Saskia from their previous conversation, pretty much both of them are looking at any excuse to hang around the Galliard Strider.
True.
Like I'm sure he would probably know. Because I mean, I remember what, you know, the Alpha, this yep, said, you know, regarding don't fuck up with Macaulay and Balaam. So I think that would be pretty bad if we think that they are responsible for everything that happened and start to cause an incident.
He did ask questions if you're confused about anything. Lest you make a mistake in the field.
That worm creature, I'm pretty sure, was supposed to be summoned here and was very definitely a very scary creature.
Jacob just kind of observes this excruciating interaction, which is about as bad as Tlate's fake laugh. this is the least tactful way to get a hold of this person ever. He's like thinking to himself, just say it. He's gonna...
Out of character, I don't even know what you mean about it. Like, I mean, as far as we know.
Oh my god, can they just say they want to see the guy?
It's bad. Oh, okay, it's bad. Yeah, she's probably thinking, goddamn kids.
Fucking cops.
So, yeah, I mean, we could totally see him. I mean, also to get any form of knowledge, like, not that I'm against that. He seems pretty knowledgeable.
Yeah.
Speaking of knowledge and messages, even though it involves stepping on another landmine again, as Jacob just says that openly, there is something that Brightwing did want to get to. He did want to say he was sorry, and is actually inviting everyone out to go wind down in Sao Paulo. Most of the bag has been thrown out of there. So.
Oh, Topisha is looking at you. She's looking at you like, you motherfucker.
Yeah, just straight like, Jacob's like, kind of gives her like, look, I came here to send a message. Kind of gives her like, I got a job to do. He really did want to say he was sorry, because he didn't want to upset you so badly. And he kind of feels bad that he hasn't gotten the opportunity to say sorry to you in person. But yeah, he's invited you and a bunch of people out to go out to Sao Paulo. It's pretty safe, and there are some Glasswalker Havens out and about, so he was going to show us those in case anything, if there was an incident in town. And hey, think about it. How often are you going to be able to hang out with a Pharaoh? I see, that's an incredibly racist statement, but hey. It's true, damn it. We won't get another opportunity. It's a lobby.
This is true. Though I'm not quite sure if at this point Latahin would find that such a bad thing. At least she manages to keep her to have her subterfuge like in this amazing role which I really wished I could use for something else. So she stays silent and she'll nod. I see. He doesn't need to apologize. But I'm not quite sure how well I would be in a city.
That's fine if you don't want to come along. Although he hopes you will.
Right.
At this point, towards the edge of the sept, a form of Will, still in Krenos form, steps out of the Umbra. He's not actually.
They're in the Umbra.
Oh, you're in the Umbra, okay.
Yeah, in the Umbra. Yeah.
Yes, three men.
Then there is a rustling from one of the trees, and a Will basically slides down it. he's in Krenos. And around his waist, you can see kind of along one side and the back of his lower torso is pretty scarred up. There's some kind of nasty, what look like bullet wounds and kind of just flesh tearing. The kind of the fur or the leaves is not around it. And yeah, he'll hop down and see the rest of you and kind of just wander over.
Holy shit, what happened to you?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. It's just scary.
Shit, you've seen better days.
Yeah. Run into some, I don't know, like Fomori or something. Out in the jungle and yeah. Kind of looks at it. He almost looks like he's kind of like observing it closely for the first time. And he's like, head's a bit, it's not too bad.
So, you got, as she got a rite of passage? Or...
Yeah, I think so, basically. He doesn't look, like, particularly cheerful about it. Yeah, I think so. He just kind of shrugs.
You made it.
Yeah, just about.
Well, you're here, right?
Yeah, I'm here.
Damn. Yeah, congratulations, you earned it.
Yeah, congratulations.
Will does not look... he just don't look cheerful about it. Like, he looks... Yeah, kind of really worn out more than anything. And actually, he's in Krino, so he will be, like, kind of gutturally growling this. I should do it. How are the rest of you?
Fine, I guess.
I haven't been too involved in some of the larger battles in the Amazon so far. Depending on your perspective, that might be lucky or not.
There are worse things here than Pentax and Fomori, I think. At least you can vent your rage at them.
As they say, there's always a bigger fish. It would be remiss of me to set just end with them.
But yeah, I should be meeting with Unicorn in the next few days, and then it will become official.
That's good.
Yeah.
She nods as she still bites her lips. Have you heard about Ayden?
No. How did he do?
Yeah, Jacob just immediately is just kind of looks down.
Will, yeah. You might want to sit down.
I'm fine. What happened? Is he all right?
Well, his spirit is probably all right. But Ayden didn't make his rites of passage.
Oh, he failed his rite of passage, or he didn't make it.
No, he
both
joined. He joined his ancestors.
Oh, right. Does anyone here know? I don't know the rules for Hirano.
You're not having Hirano. No.
It's not that bad.
You roll Hirano if you are like having like true love to someone, or if like there is a very special connection.
Catastrophic failure. Something along like truly cannot get worse than this moment.
But you can roll willpower to, you know, try to hold it together and things like that.
Okay, I will roll my current willpower.
That sounds incredibly depressed.
That's a fail.
Oh god, he's mentally exhausted.
Will does just like sit down at this point. It doesn't look like sad or crying or all. He's just like, yeah, he's just got kind of a blank expression. When?
we heard yesterday.
The circumstances of his death are still a little bit obscured. He was tasked with, and she frowns actually because she looked at Jacob because that fucking asshole Silver Fang didn't really told anything about what happened. But she turns back to William. He was fighting a Fomori.
He's a Galliard. What the fuck was he fighting a Fomori?
I do not know. The Silver Fang that brought his remains was... He didn't want to tell much more. The only thing that... The
passage isn't... It hasn't got anything to do with your auspice, although they take it into account. But it's mostly about your tribe and what the tribe stands for and is important. When you rank up and go from clear to foster and higher,
I'm quite aware of how a tribe of passage works. It's fine. Why the fuck was he off on his own fighting some fucking Fomori? All I had to do was fucking babysit a kinfolk.
As we told you, we don't.
Sorry, I should snap. Sorry.
We don't know much. We don't know much. The Silver Fang didn't told much. The only thing that he said was that he talked with a Ronin, and Isaac Raya is quite upset. He wants to know what happened. He wants to find Ronin to know exactly the circumstances of Aiden's death.
Fuck it out.
Part of this passage was that he had to do what he had to do alone. That much we were told. Some of the people who witnessed his fall there's prone to shock when witnessing death as we are, so they were not in a position to give the full story at the time. Right. But he fought extremely hard.
Sounds fucking messed up. I'm an Arun and I didn't have to fight anything, really. It was pure chance we ran into something in the jungle. For him to be set to... He's a Galliard. Why was he fighting some Fomori on his own?
Some of the people sent with him were sent to clear parts of the path. I think... I don't know why he was sent to fight the Fomori. I don't know who issued him this challenge. Probably, maybe this is something to bring up with the spirits. But
the only thing that the Silver Fang said actually regarding that is, yeah, they were accompanying him, but he had to fight it on his own. Yeah. Because as he said, we couldn't intervene in his challenge.
No, they were sent to deal with other creatures on the path. I think it was stated, but not what was relevant to his challenge. But we don't have the full story yet. Maybe that might be something worth asking Unicorn if you feel strong enough about it. We do intend to track down this Roman at some point. Figure out what happened. Ayden had some final words that haven't been relayed to us, and we intend to find out what those words are.
Will looks like he's doing his best to be angry, but just looks more exhausted than anything.
Mm.
I mean, yeah, as he's got fuck all willpower left. I don't mean to be snappy, Jacob. I just... Yeah.
It's fine, I understand.
There's going to be a service memorializing him, right? Or not a service, you know, I don't know, whatever we have.
Yeah, a rider for the party is being prepared.
Jesus.
We'll be holding it soon, maybe in a few days.
Right. Well. Don't really want to say now.
Sometimes words are not needed.
Well, nods along with this.
Jacob shares a moment of silence in Ayden's memory.
There was a mission today, wasn't there?
Yeah.
How did it go? Yeah.
Went fine, except Kumbhakarna frenzied during combat.
Okay?
Outside. Yes. Decimated Raya used all of her meat power to make sure that he didn't hurt anyone.
That's good, at least. He's pretty handy for a theurge. Kick the crap out of me.
I'll take your word for it. I haven't seen him fight.
He's a tough guy.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Yeah. Everyone made it back safe. From what I hear. And stopped a potentially world-ending ritual. So that's a win.
Half of the course, right?
Let me just stop off from AKFC on the way to save the world here.
Tell you what, I'm not enjoying fucking full moons these days.
Pardon, what did he say?
He's not enjoying, he says, I'm not enjoying fucking full moons these days. So, OOC, Robbie has been slightly remiss and hasn't, I don't think I've done any scenes on a full moon, but his force, change transformation, false transformation for me, so the other cores would probably be aware that he spends 3 days a month in Krenos, no matter what. Although, to peace, I wouldn't be aware.
Yeah, I mean, right now she's more thinking, oh, okay, that's, thinks it's fancy, that's his thing.
I can imagine. It's already hard enough.
It's a bit better her leaves are cooler than fur, but...
You have to piece her to thank for the cool breeze.
Mm.
And a friend.
Has Will seen your Newman before?
Let me think. Well, I don't think we've seen in the Umbra before, so no. So basically, what you see is you see a an ice elemental. It's an ice elemental, except that it wear a mask. It wear a mask on its face, a mask like this one.
Cool.
And it's you can feel, probably you didn't catch on that, being focused on, you know, everything that just washed all over Williams.
I think he would have just assumed it was a spirit of some kind, or just not paid any attention.
Yeah, but yeah, indeed, around Topisha, the air seems to be way cooler.
That's your friend. It's a long way from
there. Yep. I mean, I don't know much, and his subjects or conversation are unfortunately quite limited for me. As she turns to it, isn't that right, buddy? And it makes sounds, but it's more akin to sound of ice, you know, rubbing together. Because none of us has pure speech.
Apart from Tlate, who understands perfectly what the spirit is saying, and everyone else is just like, oh.
But,
kind of shakes his head and he's just like, well, it's good to have friends.
She nods. Yeah, he's been following me around since my first change, apparently. I think he's called Newman.
Oh, hello, Newman.
As it looks it looks at William and probably approach it and boop it on the snoot with a cold touch, like touch, and then just trots back to Topisha.
And personal air conditioning, not bad. I'd like one of those.
I'm not exactly sure how it works, but I'm pretty sure that if, you know, if you get in touch with a theater, it could be arranged. Even if I'm not sure that the dragon that we faced before was quite happy with that. He's cooling right now, but the last time he was throwing ice spike at the thing. As she looks at William, because, you know, she kind of realized that you're kind of a tree person.
Yeah.
As she goes, well, I mean, you gotta thing going for yourself also. As she looks at him.
Yeah. Apparently I'm a bad man. I have the spirit of a tree. Which is nice. You will actually notice as well that the trees in the Umbra do tend to kind of gravitate towards William, because he also has spirit curiosity. So there'll be like vines or grass or maybe even kind of roots just kind of like pestering him or stroking him and stuff. It doesn't pay him any attention. In all the songs the Galliards sing, it's always like heroics and badass and this and that and this and that, and it's not at all, it's just fucked. It's just people, you know, dying and killing fucked up creatures that are, there's not even any glory in it. They're just victims of the worm as well.
As she looks at him with a very serious face, there seems to be a tale behind what you're saying.
Maybe. I met a kinfolk the other day who wanted nothing more than to be a guru. Nothing more. If he knew what I was like. At least if you're a kinfolk, you can buddy go to the shops or go to the cinema or something.
She's going to look at him with a very serious look. Do you know what a kinfolk does?
What do you mean, do I know what a kinfolk does? Yeah, they help us out.
I'm just saying that if you
fucking sign at me, if you got something to say, go on.
Life of a kinfolk is not shining and happy. I've lived that life. Maybe not here. But going, we don't live normal life. Even the simplest thing that people do, going to cinema, going to shop. Sure. We can do that, but it really depends on who your keeper is.
Will looks deeply like he's thinking about something else. He's not even listening to you. Although he apparently is listening to you, because he then says, yeah, I know, you're right. Imagine living your life knowing that the person who's meant to look after you and vouch for you could just fucking turn around at any moment when you say the wrong thing and rip your head off. And the worst part is, what would the consequences be? Fuck all. Maybe it was a particularly useful kinfolk. Some people might be pissed off, or not yours.
She's going to nod at that.
Do
Yeah. I'm not gonna say I had that fear, because I was too young. My mother was just my mother. But I know my father now was always careful. Even when they had arguments. The fear always exists. No matter how much we may love and care for our kinfolk, there might be a day where, well, what we do for Gaia, the war that we fight, we might snap and take it on our own.
Just about sums it up, doesn't it? We're our own fucking worst enemies because we can't control ourselves properly. And when we do lose control, we don't get bollocked for it. We just have a boys will be boys. And he's looking at Jacob at this point. And he's like, massacre 30 people in a fraternity house party. No big deal. Hey.
Does he see that?
Yeah.
It was. But I can't help him. You can't help him.
We can't help them. What do you mean we can't help them?
Sometimes I'm listening. Oh, sorry, yeah.
No. I was going to say we're waiting for your answer.
Sometimes there is no golden ending. Sometimes not everyone can be saved.
No. If my dad was fucking kept his dick in his pants, or at least told my mother what the fuck could happen, then somebody might have known. I could have been careful, I could have been watched. When I came to New York, the fucking Sep could have been told potential kinfolk or Garo or what the hell ever. Instead, I was just let loose. Because that 30 people died. And the fucked up part is the nation doesn't even care. It's not a big deal. You know, the most fucked up part is I forget it. I'll just be thinking. And then I remember I'm a mass murderer, and not of enemies of the worm. I killed 30 innocent people, basically kids like me. How many Fomori can say they've done that? Think of the families. Think of how bad they're going to feel. Think of the fucking... That action probably caused more benefit than the worm. Than any one of these bloody... gunmetal freaks that we've been fighting. I'm just angry.
But it's also why you're a child of Gaia, to bring attention to this. And to make us think about it.
Yeah, but you say it and people don't want to hear it.
Most people don't like hearing what's not convenient for them. I think all of us understand that in our own way.
No, of course we do. You're right. And you're right. That is why I joined the Child of Gaia. I wasn't sure, but Isaac made some good points. But at the end of the day, everything I say is going to be hypocrisy. Now, how can I level accusations of reveling in violence at the Fjellner or the Get? I'll try my best, but at some point in the future, I'll lose it again. I'll try my hardest not to, but I will. Fucking hell. At least it's easier here in the Amazon. Enemies to kill. Like nice black and white enemies as well. Give me a pig with a skull head or some fucking monster with a gun for its arm. There might be victims of the worm as well, but at least we're doing them a service by putting them out of the misery.
Yeah. Whoever they used to be is long gone. It's basically the equivalent of brain death.
It's not just that, even if they're willing. It's just no person wants to be that. No fucking little piggy wandering through the forest wants to end up like that monster. I think there's a lot of problems you can't solve with just killing. I don't know why I'm lecturing you. I'm not the first person to think this, and I'm not... Yeah. It's not my job to fucking hand out lessons that I don't even know myself. It's just nice to vent sometimes.
Fisha is going to shrug. Seems like you needed to talk anyway.
Yeah.
Talking generally helps, even if sometimes people are not fully listening to you or will forget what you say. Sometimes you just have to shout at the world. But
you're gallant. I mean,
yeah.
Should have seen this girl fighting Jacob. She kicked some ass.
I mean, what did you say? OC.
He said you should have seen this girl fighting Jacob. She kicked some ass, and he'll like. He's basically referencing Topisha.
There's kind of a smile that cracks from Jacob's face. Two flips, of course.
I think I need to up my training. I'm getting the shit beaten out of my theurges, upstaged by Galliard Cubs.
Well,
I have no doubt there's a Philodox right here that would also chin me. I need a ragabash and I'll complete it all.
Well, I've got to represent. There aren't many of us.
What kind of looks like he's thinking? He's like, yeah. Well, you and Olaf.
Yeah. It's basically us two. Philodox Senior and Philodox Junior.
Judge Dredd and Judge Hershey.
Pretty much.
just want the older kids to notice me.
Fuck that, I'd rather they don't notice me.
Sometimes I think one of them has noticed me a bit too much.
Who's that?
One of the Battlemasters.
Really?
I'm not... Something was off. Either my gift was backfiring horribly, which I've seen it do when other people have used it.
What gift's that?
Or something... sensing worm taint. So it went better than I thought, actually. But I got a bit of a grilling because I needed to ask her if she'd been cleansed recently because there was an awful lot of worm taint coming off her.
You asked one of the Battlemasters if they'd been cleansed recently.
I can't not act on
that's fucking amazing, mate. Well done. That's beauty.
Yep, that's a rather contrition. That's a rather contrition right there.
That's amazing.
It was the Silver Fang as well, of course. It had to be her.
Oh, I love it.
There was something fucking there, though. But, Jesus Christ, I don't know what the fuck it was.
Did you have to do a put your hands behind your backs.
Oh, fuck. I don't know. I'm gonna, next time she's around the trial again, just to double verify, because if it's a happening again, okay, something's fucked up here. Because, you know, when I did that, she was dancer levels of fucked up. But obviously, there's none of the normal signs, so.
Dude, you fucking beat yourself up. Maybe she fucking is tainted. Just because she's an elder doesn't mean she isn't. That's how the fuck we get away. That's how the fuck they'll infiltrate us and shit.
Well, the problem is I've had nothing to act on. I have to do it, but I don't know. I'll double check, but if it's happening again, then I'm going to notify someone because, I don't know. Something was off there. But I don't think she was that as bad as that. I think that might have been my gift going out of my control, which I need to work on. It requires a certain sense that I'm still honing. Still. Better than the last application I saw of it. That was pretty funny when that happened.
What was that?
It was a stargazer, a 4 hot fix, and a double tap for worm tainted. Was pretty sure they were some sort of dancer level shit and just straight up lugged them one. Until Olaf was like, no, just stop or I'm going to pummel you. Because obviously everyone else is like, yeah, that's not true. But, accidents happen. Better to make a mistake and not fuck someone up than make a mistake and actually do so, better to check yourself. Hmm. Even if it involves a bit of that old in a tribal sass.
Jesus. Poor kid. So the most happy little guy as well. I didn't mean to gee shit before Jacob, I'm just, whatever.
Sorry.
You're still a clear though, right?
Blazes for glory, I think is the name of this. Blazes in glory.
Badass.
Yeah. A new galliot. Not from our Saps gave him that name. Her name is Banshee.
She's a Fianna.
Banshee.
Mm. Jesus fucking Christ. Didn't you hear the howl?
I wasn't on Sept at the time.
Going to try to keep a poker face.
Let me destroy this poker face for you. I'm currently destroying a poker face.
Yeah, I should start to use my supporter merit and say fuck you.
I won't be winning because I'm in Lutus.
Yeah.
Actually, I would have won that one even without Lupus because I've got 4 normal successes.
I think it's crazy that you get empathy bonuses in Lupus. It makes no sense.
It's not empathy bonus. It's more, yeah.
It's perception. That's why it's so broken.
Yeah, exactly. It's just silly. But anyway, whatever.
But yeah, no. What the thing that you see with your 2 successes against my 3. Is that, you know, when you say, oh yeah, she's a Fianna and all, like, she, you get a twitch.
This is not Flinker and Hatred here.
You get a twitch from Tapisha, but also you see that she has a smirk on her face. And it seems to be a mix of kind of, you, Fianna. And on the other hand, it's, yeah, challenge.
Yeah, no. I don't know how she managed to sound like that. I think she might have used a fetish or a talent or a gift or something. It wasn't normal. It's like 1,000 ghosts going off at once. Can't think of another way to describe it, really.
Ghosts. Bloody hell.
See her in the Umbra, probably you'll understand.
Why?
Her face is a skull.
Her face is a skull?
Yes.
Affinity for the spirits of the dead. That's actually, considering what I've had to face, that's a niche that can and should be filled.
And
I'd rather like a tree than a fucking skull, that's for sure.
She'll get up and stretch stretch her arms. Alright. I think I'm gonna make a little training before taking a nap.
Sister, she snuck off halfway through this conversation.
Yep. She tends to do that. I'll get her later anyway. And yep.
I risk a report for duty anyway. Slept most of yesterday.
She will nod at William and at the dirty copper. She'll nod at the dirty copper. And she will pass William by tapping him on the shoulder. At some point, you need to talk or vent. I got a pretty loud mouth. I can make people hear things, even if they don't want to. And she will walk off.
Well, we'll kind of nod to her offer. And then after she's gone, she's all right, that one.
Yeah, she's quite expressive. I can see where she's a galliard. I don't think she likes me that much, but I find her fascinating. I think she's had some shitty luck with people like me before, so
Remember when we first met? What a little... Jesus. And now I'll be clear out in a few days. Don't seem that long. What's it been?
It's been a few months. It's been a few months, yeah. Life runs quickly for us, I guess.
Yeah.
I mean, I could be foster in a week or something. I've been clear for like 3 months.
When we get back to New York, if we both make it out of this sweltering and inhospitable land, I've been having some ideas about things I wanted to do when I was clear, and we should talk about them. You still got friends in the police, right?
Yeah. I was talking to Topisa about how I plan to organize the kinfolk inside it to do some good with it.
Well, the more time I spend as Garu, the more I think that punching smoke is a good description of what we do. I know you don't agree with the whole thing, the whole stupid kill all the humans thing, but in a way they're right. The humans are the source of the problem. The worms that's over them is... You know, we can kill all the banes we want, but if the worm's still causing poverty and desperation and apathy among the flock, then I'm what's it all for? You know, there's still corporations selling their fucking tainted burgers, and yeah, you can't kill the human doing it. They don't know any better. But if they knew the damage they were doing. Anyway, what I'm saying is,
you want to deal with the source of the problem the way that actually helps people.
I want to use antibiotics, not amputation. And I think having some of the police of the city is a good way to do that.
I think I get where you're coming from.
Having a corrupt cop like us, like yourself, in there would be useful. We could tell Will's joking. He's kind of he's winding you off a bit.
Yeah, the inside man. I think I can. I still need a bit of time to build up my connections with my kin. But once I get started, I should be able to start getting a foothold in the force once I start. If I'm able to start moving people up. And there's no shortage of opportunity to get people's attention.
Sounds good, man. All right, bro. I'm going to head off, report for duty, join a patrol, do something. Fucking not going to lie. I'm nervous about meeting Unicorn.
Oh. Either which way, I hope it goes well.
I'll ask him about Ayden.
Yeah.
Maybe his spirit can... I don't know, whatever. Anyway, bro, I'll see you around. And we'll saunter off, step up to a tree and appear to step into it as you'll step into the Tellarium.
And I think we can end our scene. Thank you, Curtis, for playing. Thank you, Liz, for viewing. See you next time.